Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh.
wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrofil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabi ajmain. Amma ba'd. Good afternoon everyone.
Good afternoon,
Good
sir.
afternoon, sir.
First important one here. Happy Teacher's Day. Look at all of your guys' face here. You guys got any kind of gift from your students? No?
Yes, of course.
Yes, I got it.
I got it.
Okay. And then fun fact, being a teacher here, if you go abroad, especially in Europe or US, if you're mentioning you're a lecturer, they're going to be confused. Yeah, but if you mention yourself, you are teachers, they're going to give you an extra appreciation. Yeah, so maybe when you're going to travel abroad, yeah, someday you're going to tell yourself in a pro way, of course, that your guys are teacher. And then thank you for joining here, our respected senior teacher, Miss Rusmi. Thank you, Miss, for joining. And how was the first day working on your guys teaching? How was the first day on working on your guys' learning module? But it seems like no one here work overtime, yeah? I can see that your guys' face still in a fresh one. You haven't completed yet, I guess, yeah? Okay, and what we're going to do for today here, you're going to report your progress. You're going to report your progress based on the teaching document, or you may call it the teaching aids, teaching kit, and then also the learning model. Yeah, every one of you, hopefully you are going to give us what will be your teaching document or learning model look like. Okay, and I hope you guys still remember that we have several kind of the suggested, yeah, from suggested kind of learning model, yeah, from PPGDALJA. The first cycle consists of two meetings. Yeah, let me repeat it one more time. The first cycle consists of two meetings. And then the first meeting here, you can choose first learning model. It will be, for example, problem-based learning or project-based learning. The second meeting, it should be of the side of the first teaching practice that you guys conducted. Okay? So one more time, each of your guys' teaching document, learning model here should cover two kind of learning models. Yeah, one learning model here consists of the problem-based, and then the second learning model here, it should be project-based learning. And then, I hope you're going to use also one kind of the suggested learning media, such as the artificial intelligence or the virtual reality or the augmented reality. If you guys choose to use artificial intelligence on your guys' first meeting, so for the second meeting, you guys gonna have two options. You're going to use augmented reality or you're going to use the virtual reality. Yeah, that will be the things that you guys have to consider. And if I'm not mistaken, yesterday I taught you guys each of the cycle here consists of two meetings minimum. If you guys think you need three more meetings, you need four meetings, that should be okay. But two meetings minimum. Yeah, because some of you mentioning, okay, it seems like if it is only two meetings in one cycle, it's not enough. Yeah, maybe Mrs. Khan needs three meetings or need four meetings, that should be okay. Two meetings per cycle here is a minimum kind of the teaching practice that we're going to conduct for your students. Is that clear enough, everyone? Okay, now look, what happened with your face, Miss Rina? It seems like, okay, it's Friday and then I have to attend the session, blah, blah, blah. Okay, you have to take it, yeah. Okay, and then now let's try to hear some opening speech first, maybe from Miss Rusmi. Come on, Miss, do you have anything to convey first for the opening of the second day, making the action plan for our students? Time is yours, please, Miss Rusmi.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Sorry, because I have a meeting on 15, maybe half of two, yeah, Bapak Ibu. I will have meeting, but I have permission to our principal. They say, no, I must attend this meeting. So I will say in the first time, maybe that is according to Mr. Sofian before explanation upon the settle of lesson plan or rencana aksi, ya, Bapak Ibu. Yesterday we have I think there are about many participants has presented and about this lesson plan, and then I think about this is this is about special that you have to prepare about your rencana aksi or lesson plan. Maybe have you review about your lesson plan that before, Bapak Ibu? Yesterday we have many things about this lesson plan. Maybe about the technique, the strategy. And then this is about using about maybe if you use about Mr. Sofyan say IR, VR, and etc. Ya, itu ada yang terbaru ya Bapak Ibu, yang terbaru, yang paling terbaru menurut saya ya, saya pribadi karena sudah termasuk old teacher. And then you are about the young teacher ya. According to me, all of you and the young teacher say you has about innovative and ya Bapak Ibu ya. Teaching learning, so please maybe in this activity you will present about your learning media, sorry, your learning practice, or maybe we use about lesson plan. Please prepare about this, and then we'll say about according to this, is not about the new one or lesson plan in your school. That is not done that, ya Bapak Ibu ya. Tidak perlu membuat yang terbaru. Just maybe if you have about there is about your common lesson plan, have you use and at your school, have you use at your school, man? And there are about K-13 curriculum, ya Bapak Ibu. But the US maybe about independent curriculum. Please make about ITM, ya, amati tiru dan Bapak Ibu bisa modifikasi lebih bagus lagi ya dengan hal-hal yang baru yang mungkin saya yakin Bapak Ibu juga akan mendapatkan apa yang disampaikan dengan jelas oleh Pak Sofyan ya Bapak Ibu ya, oleh Mr. Sofyan sudah dijelaskan what you must be, there are about or maybe more, there is about your creativity Bapak Ibu ya, your create what you will makes about this student do at your classroom. What's your root of the problem at in your classroom? Jadi yang pasti ya Bapak Ibu tidak usah membuat yang terbaru yang diada-adakan sendiri begitu ya Bapak Ibu ya, yang mengada-ada maksudnya ya istilahnya ya. Saya nggak tahu bahasa Inggrisnya apa itu mengada-ada. Nggak usah mengada-ada. Tetap saja menggunakan use your normally RPP ya, common RPP that you use ya, that we use at your school, especially in your class. But yesterday I asked Bapak Ibu, have you tried to make your own lesson plan or rencana aksi? You say no ya. Tapi tadi malam sudah dicoba belum Bapak Ibu? Have you tried last night to create maybe utak-atik about your own rencana aksi or lesson plan, ya by own ya, by own yang kita sendiri ya Bapak Ibu ya. Have you tried it?
Yes,
we have
dicoba, ya. Pusing ya Bapak Ibu ya. Makin pusing ya. Makin pusing ya, sama Bapak Ibu saya juga kadang seperti itu. Tetapi kita tidak boleh menyerah ya Bapak Ibu ya. Never give up, yeah. Never give up to do about this lesson plan on rencana aksi, ya. Yeah. Karena begini Bapak Ibu, sorry IN bahasa, Mr. Sofyan, banyak Tapi kalau mencari ya, to matching ya, to matching about this lesson plan with our classroom mungkin boleh ya Bapak Ibu ya. Dicoba ini yang mana yang paling cocok dari RPP-RPP yang sudah saya ambil, yang ya, terutama untuk review-review ya, literatur-literatur dari Bapak Ibu yang sudah didapat dari mana saja, from maybe from fellow teacher, from senior teacher, from internet, and then browsing from another resources about lesson plan, but maybe find out about the suite is a teacher in your class. Maybe there are about 6 until 7 class ya Bapak Ibu ya. Bapak Ibu ini memegang 6 sampai 7 kelas. Saya yakin nanti akan menemukan juga ya, selama ini mungkin kita kurang fokus, insya Allah after PPG Daljab setelah pembimbingan our lecture about Mr. Sofyan, kita semua juga bisa menerapkan ya Bapak Ibu ya. Sudah mulai mencari what is the problem, what is of the root of the problem, and that it about the solution and alternative solution. Jujur ya Bapak Ibu, saya juga baru mendapatkan di PPG ini ya, walaupun saya juga sebenarnya sudah pengalaman banyak, tapi untuk saya poin one untuk permasalahan ya, setiap orang pasti ya Bapak Ibu ya, ada supervisi ya, setiap tahun itu 2 kali supervisi. Kalau saya pribadi, note-nya ya Bapak Ibu ya, saya lupa untuk merekord ya, merekord kelemahan saya, kekurangan saya, untuk merefleksi terus ya Bapak Ibu ya. Jadi nanti setelah kegiatan ini, saya sangat berharap Bapak Ibu ya, pada kegiatan ini mohon Bapak Ibu ya, please be about to presentate about your the new lesson plan has modified by yourself. Yeah. Thank you very much Mr. Sofyan. That's all from me. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
The opening speech, yeah, and then
yes, sir.
Yeah, we do hope that you guys really prepare, yeah, the result of your guys teaching document or learning module that you're going to use for the first action plan. And then for the first chance here, I would like to give a chance for Miss Tari. Yeah, look at that one. And then you gotta explain or you gotta present it here to us what kind of the teaching document that you already created, and then what will be the planning? Yeah, what kind of the apps that we are going to use, what kind of the visual that we are going to integrate for your teaching and learning, especially for the first action plan that consists of 2 meetings, yeah, first meeting and then second meeting. To the Honorable Miss Tari, Bun Tari, Sabitri, come on, time is yours, man.
Thank you, Mr. Sofyan, and I'm sorry if a little bit noisy because I'm in class right now. Okay, can I share screen too?
Proceed, please.
Okay. Okay, can you see my share screen?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. Okay. Mr. Sofyan, I'm really sorry, but I haven't finished until second meeting and my learning media belum ditampilkan di sini. Jadi baru lesson plan-nya aja. So this is my teaching document for action plan 1. This is the lesson plan. Lesson plan, this is a school identity. I'm going to teach about Batik Betawi motif and present tense and also shape and colors. This is the basic competence. Ini indikatornya. This is the learning objective. Tujuannya sudah jelas untuk melalui bacaan Batik Betawi. Siswa bisa mengetahui konten dari reading text tersebut. Lalu materialsnya adalah tentang reading text tentang Batik Betawi, shape and colors, dan juga membuat pertanyaan dan jawaban berdasarkan gambarnya. Oke, learning activities-nya, modelnya saya menggunakan problem-based learning dan PJBL juga. Problem-based learning-nya akan digunakan di first meeting, dan PJBL-nya akan digunakan di second meeting. So this is the introduction. As usual, we are going to greet and pray together, check the attendance list, lead the students to the topic that we are going to learn today, also the learning material and the achievement indicator and the others. So for the method, on the first meeting, I will use guided reading, prediction strategies, and small group discussion. For the second meeting, I haven't write the method, so maybe later on this tonight I will write it down. So on second meeting, I will use jigsaw and small group discussion juga. The first meeting, my learning resource and media is reading article from the package book of students. It is about the batik Betawi motif, the Google Lens, so they can hear the audio of the text, video about batik Betawi, and I use application which can be used in Android and also iPhone. I mean di handphone bisa digunakan, di laptop juga bisa ini digunakan. Nanti ini namanya www.iwearbatik. Jadi anak-anak nanti bisa melihat batik. Kita tunjuk petanya gimana. Di peta di Indonesia nanti mereka bisa melihat berbagai jenis batik, motif-motifnya yang ada di situs ini. Terus seperti biasa menggunakan LCD projector, laptop, audio, dan juga picture. So this is the main activities dari mulai persepsi sampai pemberian materi dan tugas kepada anak-anak. The second meeting-nya saya belum menyelesaikan, belum menyelesaikan dengan jelas. So, untuk tugasnya juga saya belum menuliskan di sini, tapi sudah kebayang mau kasih apa. Yes, Mr. Sofyan, I think that's about it.
Okay, wait a second. Okay. You're mentioning for the student worksheet, you already have the description, what kind of the student worksheet that you are going to create. What will be the
student worksheet? Excuse me, maaf, Mr. Sofyan, gimana?
What will be the form of your student worksheet?
Paling berhubungannya sama nanti tanya-jawab dari teksnya aja sih. Kan nanti yang pertama kemungkinan saya mau ngasih teks, terus anak-anak mendiskusikan seperti ini. Pertama mereka dikasih bacaan, mereka membaca bareng, terus mereka secara grup discussionnya, secara di grup itu mereka mendiskusikan teks dari isi dari teks tersebut, dan mereka mendiskusikannya lalu menampilkan di hasil diskusinya di depan. Gitu, Mister.
Okay.
Tapi untuk yang perorangannya saya belum.
Okay.
Belum ini, ha.
Yeah, and then you, if I'm not mistaken, you are mentioning your page here is 55 page for the first action plan. Really?
Ini big one. Oh, ini Mister.
Yeah.
Ini saya no not yet. Ini saya melihat format dari itu teman, tapi isinya berbeda. Saya hanya ngambil ininya aja. Ini belum up, saya upload ke bawah.
Okay, thank you, Miss Tari. And now I would like to hear some kind of comment, maybe from Miss Rusmi. Come on, Miss, for the first set of document, teaching document from Miss Tari. Miss Rusmi.
Yes, sir. Okay, yes, sir. I'm here. Putari, would you scroll down? Please, Tari. Miss Tari, why you usually say maybe? Emang tidak pasti nih, Miss?
Iya, ini maksudnya belum selesai dikerjakan semua, Bu. Maksudnya kan dari yang dikerjakan nanti malam. Maaf.
Halo, Miss.
Ya, halo.
Ya, Bu, scroll lagi, Bu. Scroll ke bawah terus, Bu. Dari
ini
atas.
Ini udah yang ini. Oh, scroll ke atas.
Scroll. Ya, terus, Bu. Before this, Miss Mentari, before this, ya, terus, Bu. Ke bawah lagi, Bu. Terus, ya. Next. Nah, stop. Basic kompetennya, Bu, basic kompeten. sudah tadi Bu stop Bu di basic kompeten. Basic
Oh, antara.
kompeten ya, 3.7 ya. Nah,
Oh,
basic kompeten
3.7.
and kompeten. Ya.
Nah.
Kompeten and kompetensi achievement indicator ya.
Iya.
Besarkan sedikit dong, Bu. Itu di, ya itu dikasih 100 bisa nggak? Klik ke 100, angka 100. Enggak, Miss Tari klik ya itu sampai angka 100. Nah, oke. Okay.
Sudah, Bu.
Oke, okay, ya. Ya, udah, oke. Okay. Understand spoken and written interaction involving words, phrases, simple sentence. Itu ada present tense ya, Bu, ya? Present tense, shape, and color. Jadi ini bentuk present dalam bentuk shape and color ya, Bu. Batik motif. Ini sudah jelas sih, Bu, sebenarnya sudah kompetensi. Understand two contents of Betawi batik reading text. Bu, untuk indikator kompetensi ini, Ibu ngambilnya dari mana? Where
Dari
you find?
dari silabus, Bu.
Oh, dari silabus ya?
Iya.
Karena di sini kok cukup understand konten ya? Dia konten
Iya.
ya?
Oh, Bu.
Understand content of batik Betawi reading text. Yang kedua, no shape and color. Ya, oke. Okay. Ini untuk pengetahuan ya, Bu. Untuk
Iya.
pengetahuan ya. Untuk keterampilannya. Pronouns and write simple word. Berarti dia harus ada pengucapan nih, Bu. Ada speakingnya ya di sini ya.
Iya, nanti kemungkinan
Kan
saya
dia mengeja ya, to pronouns. Pronouns and write. Jadi di sini harusnya dua skill yang diambil, Bu. Ini ada speaking dan writing ini, Bu, di sini. Tapi ya kok 47-nya listening ya malahan. Pronoun and write simple word, phrases and sentence by paying attention to social function and linguistic element that are correct according to the context. Present tense, drawing Betawi batik, batik motifs ya. Kalau yang 472 ini write question and answer based on picture. Jadi mereka membuat membuat pertanyaan, yang membuat pertanyaan bukan gurunya.
Iya, jadi di nanti kan ada pertanyaan tentang shape dan colornya. Jadi mereka
Oh, diberikan
bertanya,
ini ya gambar.
Iya diberikan gambar betul ya.
Cuma membuat pertanyaan ya, membuat
Iya,
pertanyaan. Berarti menulis juga ya Bapak itu ya.
Iya.
Yang 4.1 471 listen listen to simple conversation ya Bu ya. Iya, it's okay. Related ya, sudah related. Next Bu. Ibu belum LKPD-nya.
Belum, belum, belum ditampilkan Bu Rusli, belum selesai
Learning
dibuat.
object. Ya, learning object, learning material, oke okay, ya udah bentuk. Ya Bu, sudah suitable itu learning materialnya sudah suitable juga. Betawi batik reading text, oke, okay. Shape and color, ya, yeah. Oke. Okay. And then modelnya problem based learning, project based learning, approach-nya scientific type. Ya, okay. Yeah, Bu, next. Yang the first meeting guide reading apa Bu coba guide reading predicting strategi small group discussion oh ya yeah. Oke okay. Berarti sudah sesuai ya Bu ya next next Bu ya scroll lagi Bu scroll ke atas ya yeah. Next 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 main activity 15 minutes oke okay. In the first meeting. Untuk observing-nya student agipun display text sebuah Betawi batik ya, oke. Okay. Terus Bu, ini kayaknya sudah masuk semua. Reading article from Hello Jakarta Grade 5. Silabusnya Ibu tidak sama dengan Bu Titin ya, yang menggunakan Singapore itu ya.
Enggak Bu.
Ini menggunakan ini, yang Hello Jakarta.
Iya,
Hello Jakarta 5.
Iya, betul Bu.
Google Lens, kemudian the audio and the text, video buat batik, ya. Yeah. Top ya, audionya juga sih. Yeah, ya, media, oke. Okay. Next, Miss. Maybe I want to see about this, some material from you will give to your student. Materi yang Bu Untari jelaskan di apa namanya, di dalam rencana aksi ini, Mas.
Udah itu Bu, tapi belum saya buat secara apa namanya ini ya, belum secara sempurna gitu Miss, masih
belum
saya edit-edit ya Mungkin besok
Oh,
deh
belum
bisa
masih
ya.
diedit ya. Ya, oke.
Siap besok
Oke
saya
ya.
tampilkan
Oke,
lagi
Miss
insya Allah.
Mentari, good luck deh. Mudah-mudahan nanti
Siap.
ya. Ya, semoga ini ya. Semoga makin bagus gitu ya.
Ya, Bu, diusahakan.
I will be better.
Ya,
Will be
amin.
better about your LKPD. Student
Ya.
worksheet ya. Yeah. Ini
Ya,
berarti
student
student
worksheet-nya
worksheet ya.
belum. Assessment-nya juga.
Iya. Oh ya, yeah. Oke. Okay. Thank you very much, Miss Untari. Keep spirit and don't forget to prepare about your student assignment ya.
Ya, siap.
Ya, yeah, oke. Okay. That's all from me, Pak. Mr. Sofyan, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Miss Rusvi, for giving the feedback, command, and then also suggestion for Miss Tari. Now let's go with the participant, Mr. Iksan, Muhammad Iksan. Would
Yeah.
you please try to give any command or critiques for this teaching document? Sorry, come on.
Thank you, Mr. Sofyan. I'm a little bit confused about the differences between problem-based learning and project-based learning from the view of end result. If our friend, Mrs. Kuntaria, the problem is about reading, Ms. Kuntaria.
Yeah.
Reading.
Yes.
And then Ms. Kuntari used reading as a basic problem, and then he used problem-based learning. My question is, what is the result, the final result of using this method? And then what is the result if Mrs. Kuntari used project-based learning? And this is become our discussion last time about this. Several of us are still confused. Thank you, Mrs. Rusmi, and thank you, Mr. Sofyan Hadi.
Okay, would you please try to answer it, Ms. Tari?
Okay, thank you, Mr. Iksan. So for the first meeting, I use problem-based learning because I present the text about Batik Berdawi for my students, and then I will give them some kind of pictures so that they can discuss about the text, and mereka tuh harus menjelaskan kembali teksnya itu tentang apa. Jadi saya juga mau nanya sama Mr. Sofyan, I'm sorry Mr., is it okay if we tell our student, misalnya kan mereka harus menerjemah, mereka sudah mendiskusikan dan mereka masih mendiskusikannya dalam bahasa Inggris. Apakah boleh saat mereka menerjemahkannya ke dalam bahasa Inggris itu kita meminta siswa untuk menggunakan Google Translate?
Okay,
itu.
All good. All good. As
oh,
long
oh,
as
it's okay.
That's
Oh,
okay.
oke. Okay. Iya, nanti mungkin seperti itu. Nah, saat mereka sudah mendiskusikannya secara bersama-sama, kan pasti setiap grup itu mungkin punya pola pikirnya yang berbeda-beda tentang batik ini. Nah, saat itulah setelah mereka selesai berdiskusi, saya ingin mereka maju ke depan menceritakan hasil diskusi mereka tentang teks tersebut. Seperti itu, Mr. Iksan.
Thank you. Tetapi, but this is not speaking. This is reading.
Iya, memang partnya reading.
Reading.
Ah.
But the student have to retell the story based on the picture. Yeah.
Yeah.
Have to retell again the story about batik in front of the class.
Yes.
I don't know whether it is exact. Correct or not, as far as I know, if we take reading material as our topic, at the end of the lesson, we had to give, you know, writing test, because they have to understand the content of the text, and we give them several questions, and then they write the question based on the text, not to tell the story. I don't know whether my opinion is correct or no. This just it is just my opinion.
Ya, itu juga mungkin nanti kita bisa minta penjelasan ke Mr. Sofyan. Sebenarnya karena bahasa itu 4 skill dijadiin satu ya Mr. Sofyan. Jadi endingnya harus seperti apa tuh kita juga bingung. Ya mungkin nanti Mr. Sofyan
bisa. Ibu Buntari seperti itu ya, saya setuju aja gitu.
Karena nanti assessment-nya sih memang rencananya kan di situ ada beberapa pertanyaan dari teksnya. Nah, nanti saya minta siswa secara individu untuk mengerjakan soal teks tersebut gitu.
Iya.
Miss Untari, di student competence kan sudah tertera kenapa endingnya bingung gitu lah. Di student competence itu di silabus sudah jelas siswa harus apa kan ada gitu. Ya. Jadi don't be confused about this outcome ya. Yang pasti kita harus menjelaskan materi itu yang sudah ada seperti kan ada disebut saja kompetensi dasar ya Bapak Ibu ya, kemampuan dasar ya. Jadi paling tidak dasar-dasar dari yang sudah disebutkan di dalam silabus itu kita sudah ajarkan begitu ya Bapak Ibu. Kan ada minimal ya Bapak Ibu ya. Student kompeten atau standar kompetensi minimal ya Bapak Ibu ya. Kalau di silabus itu KD ya Bapak Ibu ya, kompetensi dasar ya. Jadi yang diminta bukan kompetensi intermediate Bapak Ibu, kompetensi dasar ya, dasar ya, memang dasar tapi kita memang diharuskan ya more than this dasar tadi ya. Harus lebih itu gitu. Kalau outcome-nya lebih bagus ya alhamdulillah Bapak Ibu, maka kita harus mengajarkan seperti itu ya sampai dengan untuk Miss Untari ini kan siswa kan harus mengenal dan warna ya kalau
ya betul Bu itu nanti diangkat di second meeting.
Halo Miss Untari.
Iya betul Bu, nanti mau saya angkat di second meetingnya pengenalan ya, warna saya, dan shape-nya. Tentu.
Jadi itu sudah jelas sekali tertera di outcome.
Coba Miss Kuntari diperlihatkan tadi di bagian mana yang dikatakan Ibu Rusli biar nanti mereka sama-sama kita punya lesson tentangnya ini.
Pak IKD-nya Pak.
Oh iya.
Iya. Ya. Ini Pak indikatornya jadi understanding the content of Batik Betawi.
Iya. Di situ adanya ya. Ya terima kasih Bu Buntari ya.
Assalamualaikum.
Okay, thank you. And then we have several participants raising their hand here. First, Mr. Ahmad Puadi. Second, will be Mr. Sani. Come on, Mr. Ahmad Puadi. Hello? Okay, let's
okay,
go.
Thank you, Mr. Sofyan, for giving me the time to give.
Hello.
Hello. Bisa terdengar?
Yes, Mr. Puadi. Okay.
Maybe go back to the model of the teaching, Miss Buntari. The model, Miss. You use about PBL, ya? On the first, you use about the PBL, ya? Ya, Miss.
Ya, yeah, PBL dulu, Mr. Fuadi.
So, after you, what is it? Do about the step of problem-based learning, and then and the end of the session. So what is it? Yeah, it's mean that apa yang akan nanti hasilnya untuk anak-anak itu, apakah dalam bentuk apa begitu, Miss?
Iya,
untuk PBL-nya.
Penyampaian diskusi dari hasil baca teks tersebut, Mr. Sofyan. Mr. Fuad.
Yap.
Berupa hasil diskusi. Jadi anak-anak maju ke depan membacakan hasil diskusi mereka tentang isi teks tersebut.
Hmm. Oh, berarti dalam bentuk kelompok itu ya, Miss, ya?
Ya, dalam bentuk kelompok.
Oh, ya. Berarti nanti hasilnya mereka harus presentasi begitu ya?
Iya, betul.
Oke. Okay. Oke, Mr. Sofyan, thank you. Just only step on the model learning study here. Thank you very much, sir.
Mr. Awad Wadi, next. Mr. Sani, come on, sir.
Yeah,
Thank you, Mr. Sofyan and Ms. Rusmi and to all my friends. Happy Teacher's Day here. Yeah, I'm so sleepy.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I think Mr. So Sani got very
there,
much.
There are so many gifts so many from gifts. My schools, and I got sleepy here. Okay, Miss Buntari. Okay. Yeah. Here you use the lesson plan by using K-13, yeah, Miss Buntari.
Okay. That's right.
Yeah, good. And in your learning activities, yeah, you said you use model problem-based learning and project-based learning, and the for problem-based learning is used for the first meeting, and the project-based learning is used for the second meeting. Yeah, is it right, Mrs. Buntari?
That's right.
Okay. Next, it's only just my opinions. In your main activities in the first meeting, yeah, can you scroll down? Yeah. Stop. Okay. If you use problem-based learning, I think you should do not mention the observing. Yeah, because observing is not kind of the steps or the syntax of problem-based learning. Observing is only for a scientific approach. Yeah, it's based on my opinions. Problem-based learning starting with something like orientations. But when I see your observing from number one to number five, student are given, students listen, student read the Batawi Batik text, I think it is the orientation, yeah, orientation of best learning. In my opinion, you should change the observing by orientations, yeah. It's my opinion if you use problem based learning, yeah. And Miss Buntari, yeah. And the next, if you mention the first is orientation, you have to organize it. How is your learning activities by using model problem-based learning? Can you scroll down, Mrs. Buntari? Oh ya, belum ya, Miss Buntari berarti ya. Halo.
Belum selesai second meetingnya.
Ya, yeah. maybe can you show us or can you give us a short brief explanation? You can say in bahasa your learning activities in PBL, starting from the orientations until the student can solve the problems. Ya, aku say presentation ya.
Dari yang first meeting-nya ya.
Iya, dari mungkin Miss Buntari bisa menyampaikan kepada kita di sini semua ya. Kira-kira dari orientasinya itu seperti apa, terus organisasi seperti apa, okay. Sampai nanti mereka mengembangkan dan bisa menyajikannya.
Oke. Tolong koreksi kalau saya kesalah ya, Miss. Oke, untuk yang pertama, saya akan memberikan video. Jadi ini kan karena ngomongin tentang batik, jadi saya tuh mau kasih video tentang fashion show dari batik. Nah, terus dari situ saya akan bertanya, saya minta anak untuk memperhatikan detail dari video tersebut. Nah, setelah itu saya akan meminta siswa untuk apa sih yang mereka lihat dari video tersebut. Gitu. Pokoknya inti dari video tersebut itu apa. Nah, setelah itu baru saya akan arahkan anak-anak untuk mendiskusikan sih tentang materi batik itu. Nah, setelah itu saya akan masuk ke poin utama pembelajarannya. Saya akan memberikan teks kepada anak-anak. Saya akan tampilkan juga menggunakan proyektor di papan dan memberikan teksnya per grup untuk anak-anak. Karena kan di sini tuh sudah disusun berdasarkan grup ya Pak, dari guru kelasnya. Jadi kita udah nggak usah menggrupkan lagi, udah dibagikan per grup teksnya. Nah, setelah itu saya minta anak untuk mendengarkan audio cara baca yang benar dari teks tersebut. Nah, setelah itu saya akan menggunakan Google Lens. Nah, setelah itu saya akan meminta siswa untuk bersama-sama, karena kan saya menggunakan guided reading, saya meminta siswa untuk mengulang kembali bacaan Betawi teks tersebut bersama saya. Nah, setelah itu dari membaca reading text tersebut, kita akan mencari kata sulitnya bersama-sama. Lalu saya bukan tuliskan di papan. Karena dari situ anak mungkin anak-anak akan bisa menyimpulkan maksudnya dari kata-kata yang sulit tersebut. Udah ada kata-kata yang sulit diartikan. Lalu saya minta anak untuk mendiskusikan karena sudah ada beberapa kata sulit yang mereka temukan. Saya minta anak untuk mendiskusikan hasil teks teks tersebut. Teksnya tuh intinya tentang apa? Batik Betawi itu yang kayak gimana? Nah, udah gitu baru saya minta siswa untuk kalau sudah selesai meminta siswa untuk maju membacakan hasil diskusinya bersama-sama. Nah, setelah itu baru tugas personalnya saya akan berikan pertanyaan-pertanyaan berdasarkan teks tersebut. Gitu, Mr. Lesani.
Okay, thank you Miss Buntari. I think your explanation it is the syntax of your problem based learning. Yeah. What have you said? You have to write in your lesson plan and give because you are doing by K-13, you should write the character are you going to do, for example, religious, discipline in your lesson plans, in your learning activities. Yeah, I think that's it for my opinion.
Thank you, Mr. Sani.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Sani. Anyone else from female participant, please? Miss Titin, raising her hand. Come on, Miss Titin.
Thank you, Mr. I want to ask about indicator. Miss Buntari, can you scroll up? Iya, di indikator ini kan Ibu understanding about the content of Betawi Batik reading text ya. Nanti saya mau tanya apakah is it okay if I choose not C4 or 5 or 6 ya? Karena apa namanya? Apa? Karena itu kan yang hotsnya katanya ya kan harusnya seperti itu. Apakah boleh C1, C2 gitu? Apakah dibebaskan karena apakah karena ini di jenjang SD jadinya tidak apa namanya nggak apa-apa gitu kalau misalkan only choose apa KKO-nya C1, 2, 3 gitu. Mungkin itu aja sih.
Bu, bentar itu SD. Oke, okay, come on, Miss Tati.
Yes. untuk yang masalah C1 C ininya mungkin karena ini sih saya mengharapkan siswa untuk sudah bisa paham teks tersebut saja itu sudah bagus ya Bu Titin ya apalagi mereka sudah bisa menyebutkan jenis-jenis warna atau misalnya shape tanpa melihat buku bisa menjelaskan secara langsung saja itu sudah ini karena kan indikatornya seperti itu hanya untuk mengetahui gitu.
Ya, soalnya kan sebelumnya juga kan saya pernah mendengar ya dari Miss Rusmi ngomong diusahakan indikatornya itu C4, 5, atau 6 gitu. Jadinya saya nanyain, kalau boleh pun saya juga akan memilihnya seperti itu gitu. Karena kan katanya harus yang hot ya.
Mungkin nanti Mr. Sofian lagi minta penjelasan.
Iya. Intinya main ya ke situ sih. Yeah. I want to ask Mr. Sofian.
Bu, indikator apa? Ya, indikator kan banyak.
Indikator udah ada di silabus sebenarnya.
Yang ini ya Bu, yang apa indikator pencapaiannya ya?
Indikator kompeten.
Ya. Pencapaiannya. Nah, saya mau nanyakan kan Bu Indah kan, Bu Buntari kan understanding itu kan pemahaman, jadi dia masuknya ke C2 KKO-nya gitu. Itu kan berarti belum hot katanya kan. Nah, sedangkan saya pernah dengar dari Ibu kan katanya harus yang hot ya C4 atau C5 atau C6 gitu. Apakah itu nggak apa-apa dipakai seperti itu? Kemudian apakah tergantung jenjangnya? Karena ini di SD jadi jenjangnya nggak apa-apa gitu C pakai C1 karena saya sendiri juga masih bingung Bu menentukan seperti ininya gitu Mohon pencerahannya Bu. Terima kasih.
Oke, okay. Next, come on. From female participant, one more. That one, it will be my third. Come on, one more from female participant. Miss Nida, Miss Apri, okay, or anyone else? Come on.
Yes, the same with Miss Titin. We still confused about taxonomy bloom, ya, Miss Titin, ya. Itunya kata kerjanya apa ya? Kalau apalagi kelas 1 dan 2, C1, C2 muter-muter di situ ya. Jadi tidak terlalu hot ya. Kurang hot. Itu saja sih. Tapi mungkin di kelas atas ya, mungkin 4, 5, 6 udah bisa kali ya. Kalau saya mengajar kelas bawah masih C1 dan C2. Itu saja sih.
That's all, Miss Apri.
Yes, that's all, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Now it will be my turn. Let's give a round of applause, everyone, for Miss Tari, who looks really confused for her own teaching document. Okay. Miss Tari, will you please scroll up? Okay, go back from the first page. Scroll up the first page. There we go. Yesterday when I gave you guys the example, I still remember. Yeah, when you put your guys' teaching document in a simple Microsoft Word or in a simple Microsoft PowerPoint, that should be too usual. Yeah, that will be a classic one. Yeah. Yesterday I told you at least you have to use Canva, you have to use Vectasy, or you have to use any kind of apps that gonna help you out in making your teaching document here based on visual. It is an interesting one. To be honest, looking at this one in a form of Microsoft Word and another complete, what is it? Another complete editing. Look at that one, the line that we got on the right side. Yeah, it is not a complete one. Yeah, it is a board kind of teaching document. That will be my first comment. How for you, Miss Tari? Okay, now next slide, please. Next slide. Okay. Oh, no. Second page, please. Okay, look at this one. This is a random kind of painting, and then it will be more relevant if you put it in, what is it? In some kind of Canva applications or some kind of editing pictures, yeah? So you can make it into a good one, yeah? Okay, and then next, please, next slide. Okay, this will be your lesson plan. And then your school here for the elementary level or primary level subject. Okay, the learning material, it is about the Batik Betawi. And then your focus on the sub material here is for the grammars, yeah, on the present tense or the structure, shapes and then color. And then the time allocations here, it is for 2 meeting. Next, come on, basic competence. Okay. Okay, for the basic competence here, you gotta put it based on what kind of the topic, what kind of the subtopic that you have, right, Miss Tari? Okay, you focus here on, what is it? On Betawi, Batik Betawi, and then present tense, and then also shapes and color. So where from this basic competence that you mentioning, yeah, relevant with your topic, with your material here. Okay, you gotta revise this one. Next, please. Next slide. Okay, for the B here, you're mentioning also indicators of competence achievement. You're mentioning different kind of skill, yeah, spoken and written. It means speaking and then writing. Yeah, and then you're mentioning also we have present tense shapes and color with the team drawing Betawi batik motifs. Okay, simple conversation of shapes and color, right? Question and answer based on pictures. Yeah? From B, the point of B here, I hope you are going to remember what was the first main problem that you are going to solve for this one. What is it, the main problem that you gonna solve for the first action plan here, Miss Tari? What is it?
Reading comprehension about Batik Betawi, sir.
Okay, so it will be focused on student reading skill. Yeah? Okay, when you're going to focus on reading, so you have to focus on mentioning all the element of reading, I guess. That should be better. Yeah? Do not focus or do not mention speaking, do not mention some kind of the present tense of it. Yeah, focus only on the element of reading. What is it? It will be a simple reading, it will be a reading comprehensions or any details of reading. Because that was the main problem that you're going to solve for the first action plan. Can you see the point, Ms. Tari?
Yes, Mr. Yes.
Okay, come on, next. Next, now we can see the learning objective. Okay, reading the Betawi batik text, content, okay. Okay. Okay, look at that one also, you're mentioning through listening activities, yeah? So, one more time, I hope you're going to focus your learning objective, you pick only one skill, because it is for the elementary level or for the primary level. If it is for junior high or it is for senior high, that's okay to mix all the skill in one time, that should be okay. But since your focus here, it is for the primary level, it will be better for you to focus only on the student reading skill. That will be better. Okay? And then next one, learning materials. Yeah, Betawi. Okay. When I mentioned about the learning material as one of the document that you have to put on your teaching document, I hope you're going to put it here also. What kind of the Betawi batik reading text that you're going to put? Yeah, and then why it is an interesting one? What kind of shape and color that you're going to provide for your students? Yeah, what kind of making question and answer based on pictures? Yeah, where's the pictures of it? Yeah, so I hope you're going to make it complete. Yeah, because this will be one of the elements of your teaching document that you gotta provide it comprehensively. Okay, the learning material consists of this kind of text, this kind of article, this kind of games, this kind of the pictures. Yeah, so your student, they're gonna get the point of each of the explanation that you're going to share with them. Okay, next one, learning activities. Okay, for the learning model, you're mentioning both of the learning model here, problem-based learning and then project-based learning. Try to focus in choosing only one. So for example, the first meeting you're going to use, problem-based learning, and then try with the explanation, what will be the syntax of the learning process that you're going to do while using problem-based learning. Okay? And then for the second meeting, you're going to focus on project-based learning. And then also you have to mention the syntax of a project-based learning. Okay, Ms. Tari? Okay, and the next one, you're mentioning about scientific approach, TPAC. Okay. Okay, and then for the learning resources and media, okay, you are using Google Lens to hear the audio of the text. Do you have this device in your school? Miss Tari, Google Lens. Do you have it or no?
Actually, nanti maksudnya mau di ini di handphone, nanti ditaruh di audio pakai Bluetooth gitu, Miss.
Okay, all good. As long as it is a Google Lens, yeah, to hear the audio of the text, that should be okay. So that's referred to, what is it? We can call that was the artificial intelligent kind of things, yeah? A machine learning of it. And the next video batik, okay? And then in focus, laptop audio and then picture. Okay, and then for the learning resources, hopefully you're going to put more. What will be the rest of the learning resources that you're going to use to support your teaching practice? Okay. Next slide, please. Next.
Udah habis, Mister. Second meeting-nya belum.
Okay, thank you very much. So
the
now let's
next
try
meeting,
to...
I will give you the correct one.
Okay. Hopefully, you're gonna give us the correction, the revisions. Now let's try to answer some of your guys' questions. Yeah, starting with Miss Titin and then also Miss Api, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, what kind of things that we are going to provide for these students? It is in a primary level. It is for the lower class or it is for the upper class? Yeah, the answer, Miss Titin, and then also Miss Apri, and then the rest of you that questioning. Yeah, what kind of pots should we use? Pots, or should we use a lot? Yeah, or we should use more? Yeah, okay. And then the answer, it will be based on the level that you guys teach for, especially for the primary level. If it is for the first grade, second grade, yeah, of a primary level, it is impossible for you to run with the hot thing, yeah, because it will be really difficult for that. Yeah, we are going to start with the medium. What is it? Starting with the lower first, and then we can go with the medium, yeah, mods, and then we can go with the hot things. Hot things here for the upper level, for the primary school, that should be okay. Yeah, is that clear enough for you, Miss Titin, and then Miss Apri? One more time, you can see the level of the student that you are going to teach. If it is from the first grade, second grade, okay, just be wise, just use the lot one. Yeah, okay. And then if it is the upper one, so you gotta consider using mod, yeah, medium, yeah, and then you can go higher using hot if you really sure that your student, they're going to catch all of your guys' instruction in an easy way. You don't have to push it. You don't have to, what is it? Okay, first grade, second grade, we're going to use mod, medium, level, and then hot, higher thinking skill, and then blah, blah. That's gonna make your teaching and learning here gonna make the student confused. They're gonna feel dizzy. What is it? Why did we have to learn this one and then blah, blah, blah. That will be the answer. Okay, Miss Titin and Miss Apri. And then also for the question from Mr. Sani, I guess that's really clear, yeah, Mr. Sani. When you try to implement any learning model, starting with problem-based learning or in a project-based learning, you gotta mention it, all the syntax of it. Syntax here is the step that we do in implementing the learning model. Okay, you're gonna try to learn more. What will be the focus on implementing problem-based learning? Yeah, and then in implementing also a project-based learning. Yeah, Miss Tari, you gotta consider also the suggestion from Mr. Sani. Yeah, so we can see the difference. The first meeting, you are using problem-based learning. This will be the syntax of it. This will be the step that you are going to do. Yeah, the use of problem-based. And then when you turn your second teaching practice into a project-based learning, you're going to come. Okay, this will be the syntax of it. This will be the first thing, the preparations. This will be a process of discussing of the project. This will be the guidance for the student to do the project. This will be the scoring criteria for the students to do the project. And then this will be the product. Yeah, the product that they're going to create as the result for the project-based learning. Okay, Miss Tari.
Okay, Mr. Sofian.
Okay, what happened with you? Why suddenly did you talk slowly? Okay. Okay.
Baru pindah ruang tadi, maaf, Mr. Sofian.
Okay, I guess that should be my suggestions. And then one more time, hopefully you are going to come with a different kind of form, yeah, for your teaching,
yes,
document.
Okay.
Not an old classic Microsoft Word, Microsoft PowerPoint. You're going to make it first time that we see your teaching document. Wow. It is a 21st century teachers that creating the teaching document. But while looking at your teaching document right now here, I remember when I was my
when I was in my first degree, yeah, my first degree on 2004. Yeah, that was my first time I'm joining English department. Yeah, that was 2004, and then now we are in 2022, and then you're still using the same kind of things for it.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay. Miss Nida Nur Asia raising her hand. What is it, Miss? Come on.
Yes, Mr. Sofyan. I wanna ask to Miss Buntari. It's about point four in main activities.
It is Miss Bumbun, Bubun, or Miss Tari?
Miss Bubun.
Miss Bubun. Okay.
Susah disebutnya, nggak apa-apa.
Oh yeah.
Okay, come on.
Okay, number four, about after reading, teacher ask students about difficult word from the text. Teacher write it on the laptop so that students can see it, then discuss. Oh, no. Tadi kayaknya aku bacanya itu how to ask the students to make a question deh. What number ya? Agak ke atas maybe? Oh, wait a minute. Oh, ke bawah lagi boleh? Oke, okay, again. Scroll down.
Udah habis. Belum ada second reading-nya.
Oh, berarti aku tadi salah baca kayaknya. I'm sorry ya.
Gak apa-apa.
Oh, oke. Iya, iya. Oke deh. My question is, maybe it is about the reading skill, and I have a difficult to teach my students in the classroom. The question is how to encourage the students to ask the teacher about the question, because in curriculum 13, students should ask to the teacher about the reading text. I really have some difficulties about it. Can you give me some suggestion, maybe from Mr. Sofyan or Miss Buntari? Thank you for the time.
Okay. Mungkin dari Mr. Sofyan.
Okay, try it first. Come on, try to ask first.
Okay. Kalau aku, Miss Nida, semakin kesini ngajarin anak tentang reading, cara begini alhamdulillah selalu efektif. Jadi kita nyari kata-kata yang sulitnya dulu tuh, napas udah dari situ saya suruh diskusiin, jadi mereka udah cukup ngerti. Karena kan kalau mereka diskusi bareng-bareng tuh mereka senang gitu, maksudnya ini tentang apa sih, tentang apa gitu. Nah jadi mereka tuh, oh ini kayaknya artinya ini deh, ini gitu. Jadi mereka karena kan tadi saya sebelumnya nanya ke Mr. Sofyan, boleh nggak sih sebenarnya kalau kita pakai Google Translate si anak-anak ini, cuma ternyata kan boleh, tapi kalau di SD itu kan emang jarang banget anak-anak bawa handphone kecuali kita ada proyek tertentu gitu. Nah mungkin jadi mereka ya walaupun menduga-duga, pas mereka bener tebakan mereka tentang kata itu benar tuh mereka excited gitu.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah, thank you very much, Miss Buntari.
Kalau dari pengalaman saya.
Okay, do you need more answer from me, Miss Nida? I don't think so. That's enough. Yeah.
Okay.
Mr. Sofyan.
Hello.
Tadi saya yang hanya fokus satu itu a perception-nya ya. Only one upper section for elementary. Tadi Miss Tari more than one.
Two skill maksudnya Miss Tari.
Yeah.
Okay. You should focus in one skill. That should be better, I guess.
One skill.
Yeah. So not asking them to do a speaking thing, to do a listening thing, and then to do all the things in one time. Yeah. Because that's gonna make them confused.
One skill.
Yeah.
Hello, okay. Miss Buntari.
Yes, Mr. Sunny.
Yeah, Miss Buntari, one more.
Oh, one more saya terima. Apa?
Yeah. I think in your first action plan, you should use project based learning. Oh, yeah, you said so. Yeah, project based learning. You can finish it into two meeting. Yeah, if you use the first meeting by problem-based learning and the second meeting you use project-based learning, I think project-based learning, it's really hard or is it impossible if we have to complete in one meeting if you use project-based learning? Yeah, I think if you use project-based learning, it will make you easier to complete first action plan. Yeah. Thank you.
Mungkin ya, Mr. Sunny, thank you. Mungkin saya butuh masukan juga gini ya, kan rencananya itu mau coba di second meeting itu karena ini masih tentang motif Betawi dan shapes. Jadi nanti di second meetingnya itu saya akan minta, saya akan berikan si motif-motif Betawi ini, minta anak untuk apa namanya? Is it okay if maksudnya pengen mewarnai sesuai kata-kata yang saya bilang shape-nya ini warnanya ini gitu. Nah, terus nanti pas itu kan udah hasil dari karya mereka atau mereka bisa bikin motif sendiri. Nah, nanti dari situ saya minta mereka menjelaskan juga lagi sih ini di motif batik Betawi ini yang ini tuh terdapat bentuk yang ini dengan menggunakan warna yang ini gitu. Menurut Mr. Sunny atau Mr. Sofyan bagaimana?
Yeah.
Okay, come on, proceed.
Yeah, kalau menurut saya lebih mudahnya lebih baik kan pakai project based learning. Jadi satu kesinambungan antara first meeting dengan second meeting. Jadi nggak tumpang tindih karena kalau saya kalau project based learning itu kalau diselesaikan dalam satu kali pertemuan itu cukup sulit. Nggak ibaratnya tuh sangat sulit dan impossible gitu loh. Project based learning itu diselesaikan dalam satu hari.
Oh.
Jadi menurut saya biar lebih memudahkan Miss Buntari di first meeting sama second meeting lebih baiknya pakai project based learning yang pertama nanti kedua dilanjutin lagi kalau menurut saya jadi lebih memudahkan. Thank you.
Okay, thank you Mr. Sunny. So you were not listening to the instruction then, yeah? I told you I guess yesterday and then previously I also mentioned it. You guys have two kind of learning model that you are going to implement in one cycle consists of two meeting. First meeting, you may choose problem-based. Second meeting, you may choose project-based or the other side, that should be okay. If you're mentioning, it will be impossible to implement project-based learning in one meeting. Yeah, I guess that's not true. Yeah, so when you're going to implement the project based learning in a single meeting, focus only what kind of the preparations, focus only what kind of the guidance that you're going to give for your students, focus on how that they are going to make their project. So the kind of project of the student, it's not in a single meeting, but they're going to have a time to complete their, what is it? To complete their project. As the final product of the project-based learning. Focus only on what is it? Giving them the instruction, giving them the guidance, how that they are going to complete their project. So they are not gonna make their project in a single meeting. The meeting here consists on giving the instructions, giving the descriptions, giving also the, what is it? The things that they have to consider while making their product. Okay, Mr. Sunny? Okay, come on. Anyone else, please? No? Okay, there's only one participant. We need many participants.
Yeah, Mr. Iksan, want to speak.
Okay, come on.
Yeah, I very happy. There are so many participants take part in this discussion. I think Mr. Sofyan Hadi very clearly explained about this. We have to use one method in the first meeting and one method in the second meeting. The first one, we use PBL or PGBL. It is depend on the teacher, maybe, Mr. Sunny. If we give many question, many tasks to the student, I think the time will be over. We have to consider how many problem, how many questions that we will give to our students. So we have the time is we have to decide the we have to consider the time that we will use. I think this is the point. If you give more question, of course, the time will be long. But we, if we give the student not too many question, I think that we use only one. You know, we don't have to continue in the next session. I think that's enough. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Iksan.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Iksan, for giving the command. And then that's enough, I guess. Let's give a round of applause, everyone, for Miss Tari. I hope tomorrow, when we are going to have the last meeting, you're going to have your revisions, and then we are not going to see a longer and all a classic kind of teaching document. Okay, Miss Tari, thank you very much. And I'm going to give you a chance to pick anyone from your friends here that you want to see for the second. Come on, Miss Tari.
Yeah, RPP-nya Mr. Soft ID, Mr. Ahmad Sani.
Sorry, okay. I'm not yet making teaching my document.
Wah, curang. Aku udah ditembak sama Mr. Sofian tuh baru saja. Kasih lihat.
Maybe tomorrow I'm going to make it my teaching document.
Okay, then I will choose, I don't know, maybe Miss Titin. Have you done your lesson?
Would you please mail one?
Oh, mail? Mail? Okay, mail. Then I'll put Mr. Iksan. Oh, ada yang alhamdulillah lagi. Mr. Iksan, please.
Before me, barangkali ada yang lebih siap dari saya.
Yang alhamdulillah siapa tadi?
Alhamdulillah masih buntari ya, alhamdulillah.
Wah, aku udah alhamdulillah ini udah selesai. Mau PR-nya banyak.
Ini mau dibantu Bapak Ibu, we will help your set dokumen ke depan.
Oh, Mr. Sofian, maaf sebentar.
Kalau saya jujur belum buat Bapak Ibu, bujur belum buat, tapi udah kebayang.
Ada yang belum ini, Mr. Sofian, ini berarti satu action plan ini sampai habis, sampai semua ada dari assessment itu satu action plan ya. Saya boleh nggak sih naruh langsung misalnya metodenya dalam dua meeting gini? Kayak yang ini.
Halo.
Okay, I guess confused if you're going to put it here. Like the previous one, you mentioned two learning models, and then that's not really clear, I guess. You have to put it separately, I guess.
Yeah? Okay. Yes, okay, thank you.
Okay, please pick one male student, and then it is forbidden to
retake male.
Please, just mention the name. They
get a present.
Come on.
Oh, Mr. Fuad D.
Okay. Okay, come on, Mr. Ahmad Fuadi. You have to explain your teaching document, sir.
It is my...
Mr.
Sofian Adi, this is my turn.
Yep, your turn, sir. Please, you gotta impress us. Come on.
Okay. Just hanya seadanya saja, Mister. Ya, saya perlu masukan dari.
Oh, good. Mr. Even if it's only a single page Microsoft Word, that should be okay.
Okay, I'm going to share my RPP. Okay, I need a comment. I need a suggestion from Mister Sofian, from Miss Ugun, and all my friends. Oke. Okay. Wait, sir. Okay, can you see my RPP, sir?
Yeah, come on, proceed, please.
Okay, this is my RPP, and this is about the school identity, and I'm very sorry, I'm in administrator room. There is a small, what is it, small, very, very noisy. It's okay. Yang A, di sini ada kompetensi dasar dan indikatornya.
kami mengambil dari silabus 310 menganalisis fungsi sosial struktur teks dan unsur kebahasaan pada teks naratif di sini, Mister. Kemudian 410-nya menangkap makna teks naratif lisan dan tulis berbentuk cerita rakyat sederhana. And then bagian B-nya tujuan pembelajaran, siswa dapat mengungkapkan makna teks naratif lisan dan tulis berbentuk cerita rakyat sederhana dengan menunjukkan perilaku kerjasama dalam melaksanakan komunikasi fungsional. Bagian C-nya model pembelajaran, di sini saya menggunakan problem based learning. Kemudian pendekatan pembelajarannya di sini hanya satu, mungkin kalau umpamanya nanti teman-teman akan menambahkan silakan, yaitu berhubungan dengan TPEC. Kemudian media medianya di sini alat dan sumber pembelajaran ada media, PowerPoint, presentation, gambar, loudspeaker, laptop,
mengetahui,
kemudian LCD dan buku pembelajaran yang sesuai dengan materi di kelas 10. Kemudian langkah-langkah kegiatan pembelajaran, pertemuan pertama yaitu kegiatan pendahuluan seperti biasa, guru mengecek kesiapan siswa belajar baik secara fisik maupun psikologis. Kemudian guru menanyakan pengalaman siswa dalam berbahasa Inggris. Kemudian guru menjelaskan tujuan pembelajaran atau kompetensi yang akan dicapai. Kemudian guru menyampaikan garis besar cakupan materi dan penjelasan tentang kegiatan yang akan dilakukan siswa untuk menyelesaikan latihan-latihan dan tugas dalam pembelajaran. Kemudian bagian kedua kegiatan inti, guru memberikan lembar kerja peserta didik atau LKPD 1, kemudian guru menginstruksikan kepada peserta didik untuk mengisi LKPD 1. Siswa berdiskusi dalam kelompok untuk menyelesaikan persoalan permasalahan yang terdapat dalam LKPD 1. Kemudian guru memerintahkan satu kelompok untuk mempresentasikan hasil kerjanya. Siswa dibimbing guru untuk memperbaiki jika ada konsep yang kurang sempurna. Siswa menyimpulkan intisari pembelajaran. Kemudian ketiga, kegiatan penutup ini untuk bagian pertemuan pertama. Siswa dengan bimbingan guru menyimpulkan pembelajaran yang sudah dipelajari pada hari itu. Kemudian guru memberikan umpan balik pembelajaran. Guru menyampaikan rencana pembelajaran untuk pertemuan berikutnya. Nah, kemudian untuk pertemuan keduanya, seperti di sini ada kegiatan pendahuluan. Kalau tidak salah sesuai dengan pertemuan kedua, di sini kegiatan inti yang guru memberikan lembar kerja peserta didik LKPD 2, kemudian guru menginstruksikan kepada peserta didik untuk mengisi LKPD 2, siswa berdiskusi dalam kelompok untuk menyelesaikan persoalan permasalahan yang terdapat dalam LKPD 2, guru memerintahkan satu kelompok untuk mempresentasikan hasil kerjanya, siswa dibimbing guru untuk memperbaiki jika ada konsep yang kurang sempurna. Ketiga, siswa menyimpulkan intisari pembelajaran. Kemudian kegiatan penutup, siswa dengan bimbing gurunya membuat rangkuman pembelajaran yang disampaikan pada hari itu. Guru memberikan umpan balik pembelajaran. Guru menyampaikan rencana pembelajaran untuk pertemuan berikutnya. Kemudian bagian H itu penilaian, penilaian sikap, pengetahuan, dan keterampilan. That's all about my lesson plan, sir. If you give me a suggestion or comment, I hope. Dan dari rekan-rekan juga. Terima kasih.
Okay, thank you very much. Now it's time for Mr. Speak, please, to give any comment, feedback for the lesson plan of Mr. Ahmad Wadi.
Yeah, okay, thank you very much, Mr. Sofyan. Hello, Mr. Wadi.
Oh yeah, Miss Rusmi, I'm here.
This is ninth grade about narrative text, ya Pak?
Hello. It's to be 10th grade, Miss, because I'm teaching at vocational school.
Oh yeah, yeah, sorry, 10th grade. You are yeah. On senior high school, ya? Sorry, ya Pak?
The second semester.
Yeah, to keep up analysis fungsi sosial, ya. Pak, untuk untuk student competent indicator nih Pak, kompetensi dasar dan indikator.
Ya, yang bagian A ya, Miss. Kenapa, Miss?
Yang bagian A harusnya student kompetensi saja, Pak. Indikatornya bukannya di bawahnya nanti setelah tujuan pembelajaran ya ini. Jadi untuk kompeten.
Nggak bisa digabung dengan di bagian A di sini, Bu? Atau dipisah atau gimana?
Ya, it's better indicator is there is aspartate from student kompeten. Dipisah, Pak. Di bawah harusnya. Jadi setelah student competence, kemudian tujuan pembelajaran baru indikator ya, itu indikatornya jadi jelas nanti apa gitu ya. Baru
di sini indicator of this. Indikator
ya. Yeah, it's okay. Ya yeah, boleh indikator. But untuk Papua dulu sebentar. Maybe if you are not confused, it's okay ya. Yeah. But if you confuse it about to make the or to Mr. about the student competent, it's better we have a separate from student competent and indicator ya Bapak Ibu ya. Nanti biar tidak bingung ya, kalau tidak bingung tidak apa-apa ya, if you're not confused. Tapi kalau bingung, jadi nanti Bapak itu akan mengambil akan mengukur kemampuan apa pada siswa yang Bapak Ibu ajar ya, itu lebih bagus ditulis dalam terpisah. Tapi ini yang sudah the new words ya Pak Fuad ya, Mr. Fuad.
Iya, yeah, Miss.
Is that the new words from your own create?
This is hanya merevisi saja, Miss.
Oh, revisi ya, masih revisi-revisi juga.
Masih
ya.
Revisi. Ini yeah. Menggunakan the old one.
Tipeknya apa Pak kalau di sini Pak? Kan Bapak pendekat. Tapi belum tampak di situ ya yang menunjukkan bahwa teknologikalnya ya.
Iya,
belum. Teknologikal pedagoginya belum ya. Bapak belum isi ya apa-apa saja ya. Scroll ke bawah Pak, coba Pak. Ini menangkap makna teks naratif ini kan enggak masuk ke keterampilan ya di sini ya. Tadi kan disampaikan oleh Mr. Sofyan, please point about one skill. Jadi maksudnya kalau ya memang English kompeten kan ada 4 ya Bapak Ibu ya. Mulai dari listening, speaking, and then reading, and the last is writing. But on the set of lesson plan or rencana aksi dalam satu set itu satu kompeten gitu Bapak Ibu ya. Kalau skillnya semua speaking semua gitu. Jadi kalau tadi kan terlihat di Miss Suntari itu ya di situ sudah yang akan dia less speaking skill, tapi di situ ada perintahnya membaca ya. Jadi kan itu. Jadi student kompetennya di situ. Jadi yang pasti Bapak Ibu kalau Pak Fuad ini mengatakan menganalisis fungsi sosial, struktur teks dan unsur kebahasaan pada teks naratif sederhana berbentuk cerita rakyat sesuai dengan konteks penggunaannya. Bapak Ibu ya. Terus menganalisis di situ ya materi teks sudah jelas di situ ya. Pendekatannya tipeks, media alat, media PowerPoint preparation, film, gambar. So, Mr. Sofyan, saya don't use this PowerPoint, etc. Ya. Jadi nanti menggunakan augmented reality, ya. Menggunakan IR, VR, etc. Jadi diganti ya, Bapak Ibu ya, medianya VR, ya nanti ya. Ya, VR, IR. Nanti Bapak Ibu bisa browsing ya nanti menggunakan VR, IR apa. Ya. Next, Pak. Langkah-langkah. Nah, Bapak Ibu, untuk langkah-langkah pertemuan pertama itu, saya rasa semuanya pasti akan melakukan itu ya, Bapak Ibu. Ya, check student understanding, ya, prayer, and then check cleanliness upon this room, ya, mengecek kebersihan kelas, gitu ya, kan terlihat. And then the last is a perception, and then a perception on icebreaking we give about student competence. Ya kita berikan ya Bapak Ibu ya di dalam kegiatan pertama ini pendahuluan. Jangan lupa Bapak Ibu kalau siswanya 35 orang ya, don't call one by one, maybe to make about a short time, just say who is absent today, ya who are absent today, etc. Ya, atau memang langsung lihat aja kelasnya ya. Jadi tidak di absen 1-1 sampai 30 seperti itu. Ini sudah mengecek kesiapan belajar siswa secara fisik maupun psikologis. Guru menanyakan pengalaman siswa dalam berbahasa Inggris, social chat.
Excuse me, sorry about the not stable connection.
Okay, hello, Miss Rusmi.
There could be a connection stable, Mr. Sofyan. I'm very sorry, cannot listen.
Okay, now let's try to get another kind of the feedback comment from the rest of our participants.
I'm sorry, that is unstable connection. Sorry, tiba-tiba mati ya, unstable connection. Yeah, okay, next. Sorry, Mr. Sofyan, I will continue on this from Mr. Fuadi, yeah. And then main activity Pak Fuad.
Main
kegiatan inti, kegiatan intinya mana Pak? Sudah dibuat belum?
Bawa.
Sudah jadi belum?
Iya, Miss.
Ibu anak ibu
yang teacher keep student worksheet, menginstruksikan kepada peserta didik mendiskusikan dalam kelompok untuk menyelesaikan anak untuk main activity jika menggunakan PBL ya, jika menggunakan PCBL atau PBL silakan di Bapak Ibu menggunakan sintek dari PBJBL atau PBL ya Pak Sofyan ya. Sorry Mr. Fuadi ya.
Jadi untuk main activity-nya bagaimana Miss Rusmi?
Untuk main activity guru memberikan lembar kerja ini sudah sesuai dengan sintek PCBL atau belum Pak? Is related with PCBL sintek.
Okay, berarti ini harus diganti.
Belum ya. Iya, nanti di jadi what is the student activity? Jadi Bapak menyuruh apa kepada siswa ya nanti disesuaikan dengan sintek pembelajaran yang ada di pembelajaran sintek PJBL atau PBL. Kan ini tiba-tiba guru memberikan lembar kerja. Ya, itu sebenarnya sudah termasuk ya Bapak Ibu ya, hanya termasuk juga ini keep maybe lembar kerjanya itu apa berbentuk masalah ya. Kan kalau ya sesuai dengan sintak-sintaknya dulu nanti. Kemudian siswa diskusi dalam kelompok untuk menyelesaikan. Ini sebenarnya sudah masuk Pak, hanya Bapak nanti mencocokkan kembali ya Pak Fuad ya, dicocokkan kalau, kembali apakah jadi, ini sudah selesai dengan sintaknya atau belum. Sudah pernah dibaca belum Pak sintek PJBL? Have you
still confused.
Read about this or maybe yeah, still confused. Hanya,
kan langkah-langkahnya umpamanya menjelaskan dulu, kemudian menjelaskan apa namanya materi yang akan dibagi apa diberikan tugas secara berkelompok, kemudian
ya,
setelah itu
salah satunya itu ya.
Ya salah satu ya. Itu.
Yang ini. Paling hafal sintek itu Pak Bodi deh kayak enggak kalau enggak Mister Sani.
Betul sama
ya.
Pak sama Bang Sani.
Iya. Pak Bodi Herm the sintek of PJB. Aduh. Why you say aduh. You just read from your laptop maybe from your note. Yeah.
I will miss. Okay.
Untuk ini kegiatan intinya Pak, jadi saya juga minta dibantu oleh Bapak Ibu supaya nanti paling tidak selesai satu sesi gitu ya. Ini kan untuk pertemuan pertamanya. Kira-kira sampai mana nih? Direvisi ya Pak. Ya kalau kegiatan penutup ya udah penutupan jangan lupa ya Bapak, Bapak Ibu semua. Ini siswa dengan bimbingan guru menyibukkan pembelajaran pada saat itu ya. Oke, guru memberikan umpan balik pembelajaran ya, atau penguatan ya Bapak Ibu ya reinforcement ya. And then guru menyampaikan rencana pembelajaran untuk pertemuan berikutnya ya. Oke, ini rata-rata kegiatan untuk paling tidak ini ya Bapak Ibu ya. To give conclusion ya and reinforcement ya. Kesimpulan dan penguatan apa yang sudah dipelajari pada hari ini gitu. Nah, untuk kegiatan intinya nih karena kan Mr. Fuadi will Mr. Fuadi will use about narrative text, ya?
Yeah.
Betul ya Pak Bode ya. Yeah, the material, sorry. The material is about narrative text. Pak Bode, help about him.
Oke, okay, I will
apa, yang pertama harus apa di sini?
Okay. Suggestion. The other is, please.
Untuk semua, untuk kita semua. Yeah.
Mr. Fuadi, you can ask me this night because I have problem to yeah. to find the source of syntax here.
Okay. Pak Sani, kalau gitu ayo Pak Sani or Pak Iksan.
Abang Sani, Pak Iksan. Nah,
Pak Sani, help Pak.
Aduh.
Pasannya Pak Fuadi gimana Pak Fuadi?
What Mr. Fuadi do first on the main activity? Kegiatan utamanya yang pertama apa Pak harus
itu? Pak Fuadi kira-kira PJBL Pak Fuadi ya?
PBL.
Belum menggunakan PJBL atau PBL di sini Pak, tapi menggunakan PBL ya?
Iya,
Pak Fuadi.
Saya menggunakan PBL.
PBL ya.
Oh, PBL Pak, PBL.
PBL. Nah, kalau menurut saya tadi sama seperti presentasinya
Buntari, Miss
Buntari
ya. Miss Buntari, ya. Ya, itu.
Ya. Kegiatan pertamanya ya, pertama ya harus orientasi dulu.
Iya.
Kalau menurut saya.
Pak, dicatat, tadi
kan
Pak.
Ini ya, ini kan ini writing ya, Pak Fuadi ya?
Iya, reading.
Reading, Pak. Reading.
Iya, readingnya tentang naratif teks ya.
Betul, reading naratif teks. Ya.
Seandainya orientasinya contohnya Pak Fuadi memberikan tampilan video tentang naratif teks kepada seluruh siswa, terus diminta untuk ngamatin baik secara sendiri maupun secara berkelompok. Itu kalau mau pakai
berarti apa yang diberikan lembar kerja ini nomor 3 ya Pak? Nanti ya ke nomor 3 ya Pak. Buat langsung ketik aja Pak nomor 1 apa di situ.
Baik.
Mr. Sani, would you say one more yeah. please?
Yeah, your suggestion Bang Sani.
I say in bahasa ya.
Ya, ya,
ya. Ya, ini kalau menurut pendapat saya teman-teman ya. Ya, mungkin kalau ada kekurangan mohon ditambahi. Saya juga sebenarnya bingung juga sebenarnya. Ya, sinteknya saya tahu urutannya insya Allah saya tahu PBL.
Iya, ya, sinteknya PBL ya.
Ya pertama kalau di PBL itu udah pasti dia harus mengorientasi dulu.
Orientasi dulu ya. Terorientasi terhadap masalah.
Ya, orientasi ya. Masalahnya atau materi yang kita akan mau sampaikan. Kalau Pak Fuadi menyampaikan tentang reading text berupa writing apa naratif. Nah, orientasinya nanti bisa diberikan sana secara memberikan pertama ya pastilah salam kepada siswa, terus yang kedua sana bisa memberikan tampilan berupa video kepada siswa. Siswa ngamatin video tentang berupa naratif teks itu. Terus yang kedua, naratif teks itu kita tanya kepada siswanya tentang video itu secara singkatnya aja kalau untuk orientasinya. Nanti yang kedua, setelah orientasi itu biasanya di organizing ya. Step kedua dalam PBL itu biasanya dia organizing ya. Nanti organizing ketika sudah menampilkan video tadi di awal, organizing siswa bisa memahami naratif itu seperti apa. Misalnya Pak Budi memberikan kelompok, terus dikasih pertanyaan kepada siswa tentang naratif teks yang telah mereka tonton di awal tadi, seperti itu dan lain-lainnya. Nanti yang terakhir biasanya itu kalau PBL itu dia bisa mengembangkan apa yang telah mereka temukan dari masalah yang Pak Budi mau sampaikan dalam pembelajaran, ya, Pak Fuadi sampaikan dalam materi naratif teksnya, seperti itu gambaran singkat saya tentang PBL Pak Fuadi
di
ya kurang lebihnya seperti itu. Nanti baik, di belakang baik. Layar bisa diskus lagi ya sambil kopi.
Dipersingkat Pak Fuadi, nggak apa-apa. Ada orientasi, ada pengorganisasian, ada membimbing, kemudian mengembangkan dan akhirnya menganalisis dan mengevaluasi.
Jadi inti itu di kegiatan inti ya, nanti kalau memang mau dibuat yang 3 kolom ya, yang mau dibuat 3 kolom ya, lebih bagus lagi Bapak Ibu ya. Betul. Ada student kompeten, ada teacher kompeten, dan sebelah sini adalah sintaknya ya Bapak Ibu ya.
Betul,
yang kolom
betul.
Pertama
basically-nya sih ya. Basically-nya sebetulnya I agree with Miss Titin opinion or Miss Titin statement tadi. From previous our meeting, Mr. Titin say we have to understand first about PBL and PJBL. If we have understood about PBL, we can make it into our lesson plan. Ya, itu saran dari Miss Titin kemarin. Jadi kita harus pahami itu dulu, baru bisa kita.
Iya, betul. Kalau kita masih confused ya, nggak bisa ya Bapak Ibu ya, karena memang untuk sintaks-sintaks PJBL dan PBL, secara keseluruhan saya yakin Bapak Ibu sudah membaca berulang-ulang. Maybe your application ya Bapak Ibu ya, penerapan dalam PJBL and PBL, bahkan kita sudah menggunakan Bapak Ibu, ada yang sudah menggunakan di kelas, hanya merasa bahwa kalau saya pribadi kadang tidak nyadar bahwa kita itu menggunakan sintak PJBL and PBL. Oke, okay, thank you very much Mr. Sunny ya. Maybe Mr. Fuadi, you will contact from Mr. Sunny and you will discuss from this group ya about this PJBL and PBL. Thank you very much. That's all from me, Mr. Sofyan dan Bapak Ibu semua. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much for the comment, feedback, and then also suggestions. Ms. Rusmi, anyone else would like to give their opinion based on Mr. Ahmad Fuadi's teaching document, please?
Yeah, first, Mr. Sofyan.
Maybe at Mr. Fuadi.
Yeah, Ms. Abri.
At the duration.
Duration.
Kegiatan inti, kegiatan penutup.
Yep. Duration. Oke.
Okay. Oh, waktunya ya.
Waktunya mungkin
dua pertemuan.
Ini belum jadi, Bu, masih outline. Masih outline, belum ada waktunya kapan. Harusnya sih minimal 60. Kalau 60 menit harus 60 menit ya Bapak Ibu ya.
Baik ya.
Di kegiatan inti 45 menit cukup ini ya Bapak Ibu.
45 menit ya, Bu.
Kalau harus 30 apa nih satu pertemuannya 60 menit ya Bapak Ibu ya.
Iya. 40 menit betul, Bu.
Iya.
Bagaimana Miss Apri, masih ada tambahan lagi? Oke, terima kasih Miss Apri.
Miss Apri, ya, let's go in.
Come on. Okay, thank you Mr. Ahmad Fuadi, can you give I will give you suggestion ya. Tadi kan ya,
Miss Titin.
Pak Sani ngasih ini tentang orientasinya ya. Tadi kan orientasinya ya, teks, kemudian apa namanya, sebelum ke yang Pak Sani sarankan itu, Pak Fuadi menerangkan dulu naratifnya, apa itu naratif gitu, biar anak paham dulu, baru kasih masalah. Nanti kan kalau Bapak nggak ngasih pengertian naratif dulu, penjelasan tentang naratif, anak-anak nanti nggak tahu lagi.
Baik, ya baik. Kan? Terima kasih, Miss Titin. Iya.
Hanya itu saja sih, Pak.
Oke.
Di orientasi itu, Pak.
Oh, di sini ya?
Iya, nanti kan ada tahapannya orientasi itu kan. Baik, yang pertama, ya iya, menerangkan dulu teks naratifnya gitu. Tapi kan karena student center ya, jadi diusahakan bukan Bapak sih yang menjelaskan gitu. Jadi Bapak siapin aja video ya, tentang. Hanya
mau monitoring mungkin ya, Miss Titin.
Menjelaskan apa namanya, Bapak menyiapkan video tentang penjelasan naratif itu. Kemudian sambil dipandu dengan Bapak, nanti Bapak tanya jawab tentang naratif. Kalau anak-anak sudah mulai paham, baru dikasih masalah anaknya gitu.
Ya, terima kasih, Miss Titin.
Yeah. Mungkin itu saja sih, Pak. Terima kasih.
Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Titin. Let's give a round of applause, everyone, for Mr. Ahmad Fuadi. Yeah. Okay, now it will be my turn to give the... It will be my turn to give the suggestion, feedback, and then...
Mr. Sofyan.
At 3 o'clock, I guess this will be our final participant. Yeah, 2 participants only. I'm expecting 3 or 4 participants gonna explain their teaching document. Yeah. Okay. Please try to scroll up, Mr. Ahmad Fuadi. Scroll up, please. Okay, to the first page. Okay,
this one, sir.
Okay, thank you. So this will be your lesson plan. Yeah, looking at your lesson plan, I guess it is a pretty old style of a lesson plan. Yeah, it is also the same, I guess, with Miss Tari. Miss Tari choosing the right person, I guess. Yeah, she chose the one that really similar with her. Yeah, I hope you're going to make an editing process. Make your lesson plan here into a proper one. Use Canva or use Backtracy or use any kind of apps. Yeah, to make the look of your lesson plan here gonna be a good one. Okay, that will be the first point. The look of it, visual that you make for the lesson plan. Lesson plan, since it is the first document that you have to put on your teaching document, you have to make it attractive. Yeah, so you have to make all of the all of the lecturer or teacher that they're going to read it a good one, not a boring one with using Microsoft Word kind of the document.
Okay, sir. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Have a look at the content. Okay, here your focus, it will be on narrative text, yeah, and then it will be in 2 meetings. You put also the basic competence, the learning objective, and then the learning model. Okay, I guess you are going to make it into, what is it, Mr. Fuadi? I hope you're going to make it more detailed. Try to have a look at your team, your topic here, and then you're going to make it relevant, connected with all the basic competence, with your learning objective. Okay, sir?
Yeah, sir.
Okay, and then next, see here, your learning model, you are using problem-based learning. Okay, the use of problem-based learning, it will be... Okay, we are going to wait for Azan first, everyone. Wait a second.
Hello.
Yeah.
But is it silent? Something wrong?
No, Azan, miss.
Waiting for Azan.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry.
Aku pulang saja, udah ditungguin Pak Endra.
Kalau ada dinas ada isian siap, nggak asal isian, yang sesuai kriteria, nggak yang penting misi itu. Makanya maksud gue yang waktu itu waktu pas aspek pembiayaan asal misi kan perwakilan kan benerin lapor, benerin silang, benerin kita itu mah macam-macam.
Pak Fuad, Pak Fuad.
I'm here, Miss.
Yeah, op mic please, op mic.
Okay, wait. Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay, I guess that's enough. Now let's continue. Your learning model here, Mr. Ahmad Puadi, you're mentioning you're going to use problem-based learning. But to be honest, looking at your lesson plan, there are no such kind of explanation. Yeah, which one from the syntax of problem-based learning that you're going to use. Okay. Next one for the learning approach, that's okay. You're using TPACK on it. And then for the learning media, tools, and then learning resources, which one from all of your media, tools, and then learning resources here that related with the artificial intelligence, with the augmented reality, or virtual reality? I hope you're going to choose one of it. Okay? You can use, for example, what is it? The use of virtual reality, yeah, or the use of the augmented, or the use of the artificial intelligence based on Mistari, yes, it's using Google Lens. Maybe you can use a virtual kind of, what is it? A virtual kind of explanations tour, yeah, about the narrative text, that should be okay, yeah, for the media tools, and then also for the learning resources. Okay, scroll down, please, for the step of the learning process, Mr. Ahmad Puadi. Okay, and then it is also the same. Yeah, you have to make it more detailed since it is a problem-based learning. So you are going to use all syntax of the problem-based learning first. Yeah, for the step of the teaching and learning. Next, for the main activity, please. Next, okay. That's okay. And then also for the second meeting, you have to make it more clear here. Which one that you're going to use, which learning model, and then also what kind of the learning media, yeah, that you're going to use. And have to remember, design kind of teaching practice, so you have to use an online type. And then the second one, if it is an offline one, so you're going to mention an offline kind of teaching, what is it? Teaching activities. Okay, everyone? Next, please. Next, Mr. Ahmad Puadi. Okay. For the assessment, that's okay. Next. Hello, Mr. Ahmad Puadi. Okay, where's your learning media, yes, or learning material?
I have done about the worksheet. I just only until this one, sir.
Only lesson plan, yeah?
Yeah.
So you have learning media, yeah? Mm-hmm. Learning materials, student worksheet, and then assessment instruments.
Okay.
You still have many things to complete. Okay, Mr. Ahmad Puadi. I hope you're going to make it as soon as possible because tomorrow it will be the day that you guys have to submit it through learning management system. Okay?
Okay, yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, I guess That's enough from me, Mr. Ahmad Puadi. Best of luck. And then I think you are going to work overtime for tonight. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Let's give okay, round of applause. Yeah, everyone, for Mr. Ahmad Puadi. Best of luck for the 17 pages or 26 pages of your teaching document then. And then you may stop share screen.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. And then now, like I told you guys, it is already 3:13. Now let's try to hear the closing statement, the closing speech from Ms. Rusmi. Come on, Ms. Rusmi.
Can I close my screen, sir, sir?
Yep, you may close
yes,
it, sir.
Yes, close. Okay. Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Sopian. I have prepared to go home. Bapak Ibu, thank you very much for this join us this morning. In this about maybe in this conclusion from this meeting or this activity in this afternoon, Bapak Ibu, never give up to create about your own rencana aksi or lesson plan, Bapak Ibu ya. Because there are about many I think not only many but max activities you have done or maybe apa ya Bapak Ibu, sorry Mr. Sofyan Aisein bahasa, banyak sekali yang sudah diselesaikan tapi masih banyak yang menunggu ya Bapak Ibu, yang masih banyak lagi yang menunggu. Walaupun Bapak Ibu sudah banyak mengerjakan, tetapi di depannya masih sangat sekali, masih lebih dari apa yang Bapak Ibu kerjakan itu. Kalau saya lihat baru seperempatnya ya, belum ada seperempat lah kalau saya mengatakan, baru seperempat persennya ya Bapak Ibu. And then don't be worried ya, jangan bosan Bapak Ibu, tetap semangat, tetap berjuang terus ya Bapak Ibu ya, tetap berjuang terus, tetap berusaha terus melakukan yang terbaik. Bapak Ibu tadi sudah mempresentasikannya sangat bagus, itu sudah berusaha sangat bagus. Jujur Pak Sofyan ya, saya sendiri juga membuat RPP pertama kali itu sangat membingungkan seperti itu karena tidak tahu apa yang akan saya kerjakan. Padahal sebenarnya intinya kita akan membuat siswa tersebut mudah untuk mengetahui apa yang akan kita jelaskan, apa yang akan kita ajarkan, materi yang akan kita ajarkan tersebut agar mudah dipahami ya. Intinya kan ke sana ya Bapak Ibu ya. Ya. Rencana pembelajaran itu kan kita buat untuk mempermudah kita melakukan kegiatan, melakukan pembelajaran terhadap materi yang akan kita transfer kepada putra-putri kita ya Bapak Ibu ya. Tetapi dokumen ya, secara dokumentasi dalam onot itu susah menuangkan, tapi mungkin kalau di kepala mungkin banyak ya Bapak Ibu ya, on your mind di sini banyak ya, tapi mungkin kalau saya boleh menyarankan Bapak Ibu, please put your idea ya, or your there are many of your idea to make about note first ya. Buat catatan dulu Bapak Ibu yang mana lebih priority. But I know you have make about the root of the problem. You has know about this problem ya. Bapak Ibu sudah tahu masalah di kelasnya nih. Kemarin kan sudah membuat LK 201 sampai 222 ya. 210 sampai 22 itu Bapak Ibu sudah membuat itu ya, sudah punya gitu ya. Seperti di awal Bapak Ibu jangan mengambil punya orang ya, jangan seperti itu. Di kelas priority on your classroom ya. Bapak Ibu sudah you have a problem. You have find about the problem, you have about root of the problem ya Bapak Ibu ya. Ada masalah, akarnya sudah ketemu. And then you have explored about the literature review. Nah, itu kan berarti sudah ada Bapak Ibu. Kemudian dilengkapi lagi dengan alternative solution. Berarti apalagi yang kurang Bapak Ibu? Ayo silakan ya Bapak Ibu ya, dituangkan kembali to create about the new one of ya, the new one of lesson plan or rencana aksi yang Bapak Ibu akan upload 2 hari ke depan ya. Ini sudah bahkan besok ya menurut Pak Sofyan tadi ya. Please try to make to create about the best one ya Bapak Ibu ya.
create about the best one. Because we have from another, maybe just kopas, tapi just thinking about which the best of to give about easier to give explanation to our student to transfer about this knowledge. Gitu ya Pak Sofian ya. Saya agak bingung ngomongnya nih karena terus terang Mr. Sofian, kami ini kan bukan tidak punya ilmu ya, kita punya semua, kita juga tidak malas belajar sebenarnya. We are not lazy, but mungkin maybe busy ya, busy. Jadi yang kita jelaskan itu lagi Bapak Ibu ya, itu lagi. For example in English itu materinya ya itu saja Bapak Ibu, hanya mungkin ada diperbaharui ya. Kalau sekarang di K13 itu student kompetennya itu kemudian dituangkan dalam CP untuk independent curriculum seperti itu. Tetapi Bapak Ibu memang kita perlu waktu ya Bapak Ibu untuk membaca ya, membaca kembali, to read one more, to check one more, to understanding, to maybe to upgrade about our knowledge and keep spare time to know about this material from what we give to the student ya Bapak Ibu ya. Apa yang harus kita ajarkan, dan yang pertama tadi yang saya sampaikan, kita harus mencari cara terbaik ya Bapak Ibu ya, cara terbaik untuk memberikan kepada anak-anak ini adalah mudah dipahami. Intinya kan kesana ya Bapak Ibu ya, easy to know and have fun, ya nggak Bapak Ibu? Jadi ya, yang pertama easy to know, have fun. Coba kalau saya masuk kelasnya Pak Sofian itu saya nggak ngantuk gitu ya. Saya lihat pertama itu sudah atraktif dulu Mr. Sofian itu. Sorry ya Mr. Sofian, young, smart, ya handsome ya pasti. Ya itu kan, itu sudah nilai tambah gitu. Kita juga semua sama Bapak Ibu, beautiful, handsome ya. Nah, kita tinggal nilai tambah kita apa begitu. Jadi pertama kalau kita sudah borit ya, masuk ke kelas sudah borit. Nah, tapi sekali lagi Bapak Ibu sudah punya semua, masalah sudah ditemukan, akar masalah sudah ditemukan, literatur review untuk explore itu sudah ditemukan semua, alternatif solusi sudah ada semua. Silakan Bapak Ibu dituangkan kepada lesson plan dan rencana aksi yang akan Bapak Ibu gunakan untuk nanti dilaksanakan pada apa yang diminta oleh ini ya LMS untuk melengkapi, diunggah dalam dan diupload dalam LMS yang Bapak Ibu sudah harus mengupload nanti seperti itu. Jadi tetap semangat Bapak Ibu, hanya itu yang bisa saya pesankan ke Bapak Ibu semua, tetap semangat. Memang we have about ability ya Bapak Ibu ya. Kalau kita menuntut siswa ability, kita pun juga harus upgrade ability kita ya Bapak Ibu. Termasuk saya pribadi ya, saya kapan lagi punya waktu untuk mereview review materi-materi yang sudah saya ajarkan. Masa sih 30 tahun saya tidak hafal tentang greeting card ya, kan itu saja Bapak Ibu materi ya, greeting card, narrative tag, descriptive tag, itu terus ya bisa dibilang di luar kepala, tapi bukti di luar kepala itu Bapak Ibu yang harus kita buktikan ya. Kalau di luar kepala itu apa gitu. Jadi kalau Bapak Ibu nanti sudah menemukan what the student is fun tadi ya, student is fun, they are easier, fun, kemudian we have about creative, innovative, mah luar biasa. Pasti siswa-siswanya nanti akan sangat luar biasa. Dan kalau kita sakit seperti saya kemarin, nggak masuk 2 hari sakit, kenapa? Ya siswanya sedih, bukan senang, seperti itu ya. Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Sofian. This is from my speak. Thank you very much.
Okay, massive thanks for Ms. Rusmi, and then let's give a round of applause everyone for Ms. Rusmi for giving us the conclusions, yeah, concluding statement.
Thank you very much.
Okay, it will be my turn everyone. Yeah, there are several points to be honest. First of all, today here is the second day of you guys making the action plan. Yeah, and then it's turned out majority of you, it is not only Miss Tari and then Mr. Ahmad Puadi that still working on their progress, only 10% I guess, yeah. And then majority of you guys, yeah, majority of you, you haven't completed the set of your teaching document, yeah. That will be the first one. Second one, you gonna like it or you gonna hate it, yeah. This will be the next process. Yeah, the next process you have to create, you have to make the teaching document. Yeah, it will be your guys' obligations to complete the teaching document. Yeah, and then the teaching document here, yeah, it should be attractive one. It should be an innovative one, because the name of our subject here is creating, designing an innovative learning design.
for our students. And if it is only the same as the previous one, before you guys joining this PPG Dalja, so that will be useless. You gotta think about it twice. Yeah, if you're going to present the same, similar kind of teaching process for your students. Yeah, totally agreed with what Ms. Rusmi here told us. If you're going to teach your students, if you're going to give them a different kind, a various kind of experience after completing this PPG Dalja, so that's gonna be a meaningful kind of learning experience that they're going to get. Okay, not the same one as the previous Mr. Muhammad Iksan, as the previous Mr. Sani, but it will be a new one. Okay, so you're going to be a missed teacher. Yeah, like Miss Rusmi mentioned it, when she is absent because she is sick here, majority of her student asking and then said, why Miss Rusmi cannot attend the class, and then blah, blah, blah. I hope you're going to be that kind of teacher. Yeah, every single time that you come to the school, yeah, your students come with big smile with you. Hello, Miss Tari. Hello, Miss Bimbi. Not like a stressful one, like Miss Bimbi's face here, like this one. Okay, let me. How you are going to let it go, Miss Bimbi? Try to enjoy the process of the meeting that we have. Yeah. Okay, and then not like, what is it, Miss Rina, when Miss Titin reading PPG Dalja, reading here, senyum, it's like that. No smile at all, yeah? How did you expect your student gonna smile with you guys when you yourself here, it's difficult for you to give or to share your smile, yeah? That will be the second one. The third one, I know it is an extra hard for you, since you guys only have 2 days, or maybe it's 1 day. Yeah, 1 day effectively to complete all the teaching document. And because tomorrow it will be the day for you guys to submit it through the learning management system. Make sure all the details, yeah, all the details with the problem-based learning syntax, project-based learning syntax, the type of the teaching and learning you're going to use, and online, the first, it should be an online, second, it will be an offline, or you may switch it. Which one gonna be an offline, which one gonna be an online one. Okay, so you guys have a complete comprehensive kind of the teaching experience. Yeah, and then last one, I hope you're going to ask the forgiveness from your guys' husband, from your guys' wife, yeah, from your guys' kids, because you have to taking care of this work first before you're going to spend your weekend with the family, before you're going to bring your kids, your children to visiting any tourist attractions, yeah? Because this will be your guys' priority, yeah? Okay, last one, stay safe and then stay healthy, yeah? Look at Ms. Rusmi, the way that she talk, I guess it's not really in a fit conditions, but she can join our session for today, yeah? Thank you very much. One more time, Mr. Ahmad Fuadi. Okay, remember, sir, you're going to have a lot of work to do with this one. I hope you're going to do an overtime. Yeah. Okay, next one, Mr. B. Okay, look at the outfit of Mr. B. This is the 21st century of teacher. Looking at him. Come on, that's an outfit of a professional English teacher. Yeah. Okay, and then Miss B, I hope you're going to smile more. Would you please share your smile with us, Miss B? There we go. Look at that. It's not a smile, I guess. Yeah. And then Miss Avri, thank you for joining. Mr. Muhammad Iksan, thank you for the wise kind of the comment feedback for the rest of your friends here, Miss Rina. And then Miss Siska, it seems like Miss Siska here is busy talking with her husband maybe or her kids, yeah. And then taking some kind of selfie and then send it away to her husband or to the partner, that's okay, give it that way. And then Mr. Muhammad Agus, Mr. Agus, it seems like, okay, that it is a really look of 21st century of the teacher, yeah? And then Ms. Titin, who is really smart in giving a command and an opinion for the rest of the participant, Ms. Tari, and then I love that plastic bag over there that I see your background. That's a good one. That was the gift from your student, right? No? Okay. And then also with Mr. Sani. Thank you very much, the rest of you guys. And then have a nice hectic weekend, yeah, working on your teaching document, working on your learning model. Thank you very much. And at the last, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you everyone.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima
kasih Bapak Ibu, mohon maaf lebih kurangnya ya.